Everything is interconnected. Air, land, water, and all living things weave together to form the infinite web of life, an underlying truth that is becoming more evident in the apparent destruction of our environment and its obvious impact on our livelihoods, communities, and lives. According to the World Resources Institute, 100 species of plants and animals die every day due to tropical deforestation. By 2050, half of the world's plant and animal species on dry land could be at risk of facing extinction. In Cagayan de Oro, the mining industry has recently been a cause for alarm. Large-scale and illegal mining activities, in addition to logging operations, have been blamed for the flash flood that hit Misamis Oriental in January of 2009, affecting 40,000 families and damaging infrastructure and livelihood worth 577 million pesos. Our natural ecosystems are being severely degraded and may well be on the verge of collapse, threatening our planet's overall ability to sustain life. Notwithstanding our faiths and cultural backgrounds, we are part of nature's ecosystems. Our contributions are critical in determining the future of our planet. The McKeough Marine Center of Xavier University, headed by marine biologist and clam expert Dr. Hilly Ann Quiaoit, are taking measures to prevent the further destruction of our environment by taking a broader view of how individual issues fit into the large picture.
Basically, the program of the center is to come up with this participatory bay-wide management bay we call Macajalar Bay. We realize that whatever efforts we make in the bay, unless we connect with the upland areas, of these efforts will be all for nothing. For example, if we have an area along the coast which is near the river mouth, if we put it as a protected area, even if we do the enforcement and the rehabilitation, but the soil that is eroded from the upland will still continue to pour into this area and might cause the deterioration of the habitats. So we decided it would be better if we start to link up with the upland, and we use the Cagayan River watershed as our model for this connection. Now we call the ridge, river, and reef connectivity. So with the IUCN funded project on knowledge, learning, and networking, we have identified one activity, which is the 3D mapping, where we ask the indigenous peoples of Bukidnon, our upland partners, and also the LGUs in the upland areas of the province of Bukidnon, and also the coastal towns of Macajalar Bay, to come together and build this 3D map.
With growing realization of the interlink between ecosystems, resources, and communities, the Reach to Reef initiatives in the Philippines project was born. From the Bukidnon watersheds down to Macajalar Bay, ecosystems and communities interrelate with the use of resources. The importance of this link will help harmonize communities in doing resource management and conservation efforts, uplift the environmental state of the uplands and coastal areas, and make careful decisions to avoid irresponsible acts. On November 17 to 19 and December 17 to 18 of 2009, the McKeough Marine Center and Kitanglad Integrated NGOs, together with the Geoinformatics Center of the College of Agriculture, put together a two-part participatory 3D mapping workshop to further understand the interconnectivity of our ridge, river, and reef, and to identify environmentally critical areas.
Our part in KIN is to bring in indigenous peoples involved in these three mountain regions to connect to the people in Macajalar Bay down the coastlines, the reef counterpart, and try to work out a mechanism wherein the forest conservationists can connect their efforts with the coastal dwellers. So we would have simultaneous protection and resource management working on the ground or up ground in Mount Kitanglad, in Bukidnon, with Mount Kalatungan Pantaron Range, and in Macajalar Bay, down in Region 10.
The first ever to be undertaken in Northern Mindanao, the workshop brought together participants from various sectors, namely the International Union for Conservation of Nature Knowledge, Networking and Learning, non-government organizations, local government units of the municipalities of Opol, Alubihid, Hasaan, Balingasag, Lagingdingan, Tagulwan, Sugbong Kugon, El Salvador, Balingwan, Cagayan de Oro, Kinugitan, Salay, Villanueva, and Binuangan, together with the community leaders of Bukidnon.
We are fortunate that the tribes involved in the 3D mapping are very experienced mapmakers. This is one interesting experience that they were able to construct a 3D map that shows not only the forest systems but also the marine ecosystems of Macajalar Bay. And this time we would have a bigger picture of the fragile resources, the forest, the marine, the land, the river systems, all these which are connected and that needs to be protected and managed and conserved.
The mapping workshop aimed to cultivate unity among communities in the uplands and coastal areas in their resource conservation and environmental protection activities. Since the workshop employed participatory mapping, the participants contributed to the making of a 3D model. The Lumads began each workshop with a sacred ritual asking nature spirits dwelling in the mountains and the seas to bless the link established between humans, their territories, and resources. After the ritual, participants gathered four instructions. They were grouped into three, each in charge of tracing, cutting, and pasting. Each group was composed of representatives from the different sectors. The first step in making the 3D model was to trace contour lines onto chipboards using an 8x12 foot base map with a scale of 1:35,000 as reference. Contour lines refer to curves outlining regions and areas of the base map. Steady fingers carefully traced the lines. After tracing, the patterns were cut to form layers that would then be pasted on the base map. The geoinformatics team guided and oversaw this crucial stage to minimize errors and achieve as much accuracy as possible. The final steps to the mapping were done in December. After painting the map to visualize its topography, participants embarked on landmarking or pagtutukoy, where they identified features, protected areas, cultural and sacred sites, communication towers, and coral reefs. Municipal and barangay boundaries were also determined, as well as threatened areas and locations of community projects. These sites were marked on the base map using pushpins, yarns, stickers, and other items. The result of the workshop is a relief model showing the Bukidnon watersheds of Mount Kitanglad and Mount Kalatungan all the way to Macajalar Bay in Misamis Oriental, punctuated by the various significant sites identified by the participants. Overall, the workshop had been very well received. For the Lumad participants, the mapping was a new experience that allowed them to work with coastal managers and carry out activities in the university setting.
Sa kultura isutan, wala kayo yung nakita na ako kayo, wala may mapa-mapa sa tribo. Ang ilang mapa is memorized naman ang kung saan kayo kung saan. Pero kung sa karun, kanon na napugos kami ba ang tribo pag duol sa papel tungod kay kasagaran requirements sa gobyerno is papel ang imong ipakita, dili kami tuuhan kun istorya lang. Kabahin sa paghimo sa 3D map dako kayo kung natunan kay mahimo nga ipadayag namo nga tabangan kami sa pag-alima dito sa among lugar sa bukid dinhi sa ubos kay kun unsay may tabo dinto sa taas, so sila ang pinaapektado dinhi, so dapat ilaning tutupan
mapa o sa kinihan ng sekretaryo silba. Ako makatabang ko pagtulog sa mga tao na mahoy mga dunay kalambigitan. Matulog ko sa sagrado ng lugar, mga trabahoanan, mga pangayamanan, sa mga dili pwede patuan, apil na sa dahiyang kasaysayan. O kani, importante kayo nga may balon sa atong kagamanan. Posible nga ang iyan suportahan sa pagpreserba yung masadang pag-respeto sa katungod sa mga tao, hindi natin matinig-matinig.
the local government units reported in the status of their respective jurisdictions were grateful to have a relief model that could help them chart their municipal development plans.
Ang dili mapilosya, nabahatag og dako nga tabang sa bidad, labi na sa lokal nga pagamhanan. Maayos kini siya nga ayuda alang sa mga membro sa mga bayan, paglantaw sa mga umabot ng epekto sa atong kayutaan sa lungsod sa Dagimbingan.
Dako ang makatabang ang kayuhan sa atong kabukiran. Kung mairod ang atong kabukiran, usa man kini nga makadaot sa atong mga coral reefs. Unya, kung madaot ang atong mga corals, wala na usay isda nga makuha sa atong mga marigat. So kinahalan na protektahan nato ang kabukiran, dili lang ang atong kadagatan para apil usab ang mga mangingisda ato sa mga protektahan.
As well, the 3D model intends to stir public awareness in the status of our ridge, river, and reef, as this will enable them to decide which actions to take and to avoid.
Makikita natin ang kaugnayan ng sa bundok at saka sa sa coastal area. Sa NGO naman, ito'y malaking tulong sa pag-implementar ng mga produkto doon. Makikita nila ang mga clue ng ilog, lalo na yung Balatukan River. There are times kung malakas ang ulan ay masisira yung mga dike doon. Tapos pupunta doon sa mga areas ng maraming mga tao.
The map also unites social, cultural, and political dynamics of involved locals as LGUs, academe, indigenous peoples, and civil society share current environmental programs.
Makita na to ang full perspective sa region or municipality wherein I am in. So, aside from that, kini-3D mapping it really helps the managers, resource managers, and officials, leaders as well sa pag-decide and plan their activities in the near future.
In the 3D map, it's very important that we can pinpoint what roads are to be opened so that the officials and the constituents can easily go to the specific barangay in order for them to know what are happening to that barangay and what they are going to do to solve the problem.
The 3D mapping activity is only a step towards intensifying the link between ecosystems. It will take more than just mapping activities to make the Ridge, River, Reef Alliance sustainable and strengthen collaboration and partnership among stakeholders.
This is our commitment in our Ridge to Reef project, and we hope that this continues in terms of educating the wider public with regards to the current conservation that is ongoing, and definitely we need their help, we need their support, especially from the private and the business sector, to push for more conservation initiatives and projects, and side by side working with communities, the indigenous peoples up in the mountains, and the fisher folks down in Macajalar Bay.
As the academe, governments, and communities continue to realize the importance of this partnership, one important truth also reflects in the 3D model. How we choose to live our life affects all other life systems.